Hello, friends. I welcome you to a new day. Jesus is Lord and His Lordship is forever. Can we just go ahead and appreciate Him, give Him the glory, give Him the praise everywhere? He's worthy of our praise. He's entirely a new day. He's the God that rises in the heavens by the name Jah. He's the Lamb that was found worthy to open the book with the seven seals. Lord, we glorify you. The fourth man in the fire will bow before your majesty. Lord, we are grateful. We choose not to be ingrates in a new day. You are the God of wonders. We say thank you. Thank you for the things you've been doing for us. We are grateful. We've come to mark attendance to God as those whom you have spared their lives to worship you. We worship you, the beauty of Zion. We bless you, the everlasting Jehovah. Ocean divider, we celebrate you. Lord, we say thank you. The glory of Damascus, we say thank you. The dependable God, the covenant keeping God, we say thank you. You are faithful, too faithful to fail us. We bow and we reverence you. The one that was found worthy to open the book with the seven seals. We appreciate you and we glorify you in a new day. The God that has over 1,000 names, we say thank you. We give you all the glory. We give you all the praise. Friends, let's sing. Yes, you are the Lord. Most High. 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 Kalian deregede lagadush. Zinekelagademos Indra Kalagada Balegede Lagadush. Worship Him everywhere. Glorify Him. He is the Most High God. Lord, we say thank you. Sweet Holy Spirit, we welcome you into this new day. Linania Kalian Ananamos Indra Kalagadabush. We say we love you. Hallowed be your name. And blessed be the name of the Lord God Almighty. For we worship with thanksgiving in Jesus' name. Amen. Today is the 344 of Spirit Praise, and Spirit Praise comes your way every morning to build up your spiritual capacity and network. It comes as a daily dose to strengthen your spiritual cables and wires and to keep you aflame for God all day. So briefly this morning, we take our Bible reading from Genesis chapter 18 verse 17. And the Lord said, shall I hide from Abraham that thing which I do? Friends, this is one of the biblical statements made by God that we shouldn't take for granted as God's people. We are in the days when so many children of God take for granted their relationship with God. But that shouldn't be the case with a listener to this broadcast this morning. There is need to value your relationship with God, cherish it, and be committed to it. Abraham had a relationship with God, which he didn't joke with. His relationship with God was a personal one, which grew and developed into his becoming a friend of God. In fact, their relationship became so personally powerful that God had to make the strong statement which formed part of our text this morning. And the Bible recorded, and I read from the New Living Translations, Genesis 18 verse 17. Should I hide my plan from Abraham? The Lord asked. So friend, their friendship and intimacy got to a point where God could not hide his plans and intentions from Abraham. Their friendship got to a point where the two had an effective communication and trust in each other. For everyone who has been in a relationship, you will discover that friendship tends to grow as the trust you have for each other grows. Over time, it matures into intimacy, whereby you share your plans with the person, your dreams, your future. You know, the person becomes part of you. You share your joy, even your pain. As a matter of fact, in the relationship that existed between God and Abraham, I strongly believe that the two were committed towards the success of it. In fact, their friendship wasn't the type you see in this present dispensation. When all is good, the person is there. If for any reason things are no longer in shape, that friend will abandon you. I believe I have some witnesses in the house. Hear me, friend. In such time, just keep your focus on Jesus, the best friend that can never fail you. And never forget that the same multitude that shouted, Hosanna, Hosanna, blessed is he that comes in the name of the Lord, was the same crowd, the same multitude that shouted, crucify him, just couple of days after. So friend, what am I saying? watch. I believe someone is wondering, how come God, the Almighty One, the one who made the heavens and the earth, the commander-in-chief of the entire universe, should become a confidant to Abraham? In fact, your guess is as good as mine. But wait a minute, God took me to Genesis chapter 12 and told me this was where it all started. So look at Genesis chapter 12 verse 1. Now the Lord said unto Abraham, get thee out of thy country, and from thy kindred, and from thy father's house, and unto a land I will show thee. Now look at verse 4. So Abram departed as the Lord had spoken unto him, and Lot went with him. And Abram was 75 years old when he departed out of Haran. So friend, at 75, Abram obeyed. He listened to what God told him to do without argument, without putting public opinion into consideration. Abraham was in absolute obedience to God's will and purpose. Even when God gave instruction concerning his only son, Isaac, Abraham was in absolute compliance. Now look at what I'm saying in Genesis 22 verses 2 to 3. And he said, take now thy son, thy only son Isaac, whom thou lovest, and get thee into the land of Moriah, and offer him there for a burnt offering upon one of the mountains which I will tell thee of. And Abraham rose up early in the morning, and saddled his ass, and took two of his young men with him, and Isaac his son, and cleft the wood for the burnt offering, and rose up and went unto the place of which God had told him. So friends, what am I saying? Over time, the relationship between God and Abraham grew based on obedience. I strongly believe that God is calling someone listening to this broadcast into the place of obedience. And hear me, friend, your compliance will birth an intimacy. And intimacy will give you all you need in the now and eternity. It will give you opportunity to divine privileged information like Abraham had from our text. Should I hide what I want to do from Abraham? In fact, in going through the scripture, I have come to discover that the relationship between God and Abraham was that of a high degree, a relationship that made God to swear by himself after Abraham obeyed him. Now look at Genesis 22, 16 to 17. It says, and said, by myself have I sworn, saith the Lord, for because thou hast done this thing, and hast not withheld thy son, thy only son, that in blessing I will bless thee, and in multiplying I will multiply thy seed as the stars of heaven, and as the sand which is upon the seashore, and thy seed shall possess the gates of their enemies. It might interest you to know that Abraham enjoyed an intimacy with God till he died at the good old age of 175. That is called longevity. And I decree and declare unto you, may your days be long in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Now, do you know that up to today, every believer in Christ is connected to the Abrahamic covenant of blessing based on the friendship, commitment, and obedience of Papa Abraham? No wonder the Bible says in Isaiah 41 verse 8, but thou Israel art my servant, Jacob whom I have chosen, the seed of Abraham, my friend. So friends, God knew Abraham as his friend and called him Abraham, my friend. As we pray, I came to remind you this morning that God is still interested in getting involved in every department of your life. He's still interested in showing himself friendly to as many of his children that are prepared and interested to go through the process. To such, he will show them his secret. In fact, he will disclose some hidden things to them, and he will reveal his plans to them. If I may ask, how prepared are you today to be his friend like Abraham was? Let us pray. I would first of all like to pray for someone who has listened to this broadcast, but you have no personal relationship with Jesus. Permit me to say that the first step to becoming a friend of God is by accepting the Lord Jesus Christ as your Lord and personal Savior. Such persons, can you just quickly say after me, my Father in heaven, I come to you this morning. I'm a sinner. Lord Jesus, come into my heart. Be my Lord and my personal Savior. Give me the power and the grace to serve you and to live for you all the days of my life. Thank you, Lord Jesus, for serving me. Take all the glory. In Jesus' matchless name we prayed. Amen. And I decree and declare that this decision you have just made shall forever remain permanent in Jesus' name.
Amen. Friends, let's go. Kalia kagadaba legedede lagadush. Line kelegedede mos indra kalagadabush. Shantaraba kalian deregedede lagadush. Listen to me, child of God. God is in search of men and women who can come into the secret place so that he can disclose some secrets to them. I invite you, let's go into the secret place in the tongues of the angels. He that speaketh in tongues, speaketh unto God. Kalian deregedede lagadush. Zine kelegedede mos indra kalagadabush. Shantaraba kalia. And the Bible recorded, and then he said, shall I hide from Abraham that which I plan to do? Kalian deregedede lagadush. Zine kelegedede mos indra kalagadabush. Shanda, pray in the Holy Ghost. Zike legedede zundorogodede bo sindaragada malian deregedede legede zukorogodede bo sindaragada. Oh Lord, do not hide from me that which you plan to do. Pray in the Holy Ghost. No spiritual cable should be weak this moment. Kalian deregedede lagadush. I say no spiritual cable should be weak this morning. Kalian deregedede lagadush. Zine kalagadede mos indra kalagadabush. Shantaraba kalia kagadaba legedish. Zige dede belegede zundoro godede legede. Zune kalagadede mos indra kalagadabush. Inde kalagadede legede. For deep calleth unto deep. Zike legede mos indra kalagada. Zune kalagadede mos indra kalagadabush. Zike legede lagadush. Zine kalagadede mos indra kalagadada legede. Zike legede lagadu. Zine korogododo bush kalagadada legede. Zundoro godede busina kalia kagadaba legede legede. For the spirit searcheth all things, even the deep things, even the hidden things. Malian deregedede bo sundaragada. I say pray in the Holy Ghost. Zikelegedede legede zuno korogododo bo sindaragada. Malian deregedede bo sundaragada. Mystery to mystery. Kalian deregedede bo sundaragada. Likelegedede bo kalagada legede. Zedegedede legede lagado. Zinderegedede lagado bo sina kalia kagada balegede. Zuno korogododo bo sina kalia kagada balegede legede. Zukorogododo bo sikalagada legede. Zindegregada lagada bo indra kalagada balegede. Zukorogododo bo sikalagada lugododo bo sindaragada. Malian deregedede lagadush. Zine kalagada bo sindra kalagada bush. Kalagada legedede lagadush. Sina kalian anakian daragada bush. Father, we thank you. We give you all the glory. We give you all the praise. We thank you for what you are doing on this global platform. We thank you for the Spirit Praise Daily Devotional. We thank you, King of Glory, for the revival we see. We thank you for the fire we see. We thank you for the outpouring of your Spirit, O God, we experience on this platform every morning. Lord, we say thank you. We worship you. We give you all the glory and all the praise. Thank you for answered prayers. Thank you for the Spirit Praise Daily Devotional. Thank you for what you are doing on this global platform on daily basis. Take all the glory. Take all the praise. Take all the honor and dominion. Kalian deregedede lagadush. We receive the hidden treasures of the secret place in the matchless name of Jesus. Lord, take all the praise. And blessed be the name of the Lord. And I decree and declare to everyone who has listened to this broadcast today that the heavens over you shall be opened, and God will reveal to you that which he planned to do beyond their imagination. In the matchless name of Jesus Christ, amen. Thank you, our Father. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Be thou glorified. Be thou exalted and be magnified. Blessed be God. For we prayed with thanksgiving in Jesus' name. Amen. Go rule your day in partnership with the Holy Spirit.